Croeso, and thank you for joining us for this event with the author Sarah Kilbride. I'm Zoe from the Reading Agency, and I'll be joining in the fun later when we take a few questions from parents and carers watching along tonight. You can share your questions in the chat box at the bottom of your screen at any point during the event, and we will answer as many as we can at the end. We have also enabled live subtitles for this event, but if you would prefer not to use these, you can turn them off using the live subtitles button at the bottom of your screen. But can I first welcome Nicola Pittman, the librarian lead of this special Winter of Wellbeing campaign, who will introduce Sarah and get us started.
Hello, everybody. I'm really happy to be leading on this very special Winter of Wellbeing campaign. So libraries across Wales, so near you, have been busy planning so many exciting activities and events for you to take part in, including competitions and events, story times and creative sessions. So please make sure you find out what's going on where you are. But we love it most of all in Welsh libraries when parents and children come into our libraries to sing and take part in story times and rhyme times and to share stories. And tonight, obviously, we're showing that you don't have to actually be in the same room to participate and take part. We're absolutely thrilled to be joined tonight by Sarah Kilbride, who's going to be leading us today. Sarah's written some fantastic books, which include A Cuddle and a Cutch, with the brilliant Welsh dragon sharing in the story as well. So what better way to end a winter Wednesday and to get cosy and share a story and some games. So really pleased that you could join us tonight, Sarah. As well as A Cuddle and a Cutch, there are other books that Sarah's written also, obviously available in libraries, but also in shops, including the Super Princess Evie series and her latest book, which is Being a Princess is Very Hard Work. So anyway, you can ask Sarah about these books later when there will be some time for questions. But anyway, enough from me. Let's not waste any more time. Let's start the fun. And I'm going to hand over to Sarah. Over to you, Sarah. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Nicola. Hello, baby bookworms. Hello. It's really, really lovely to be here. I love libraries. Going into a library is a bit like going into a treasure cave because you never know what you're going to find, but you will always find something special. And it's somewhere that you can just keep going back to and looking for more treasure. So it's really lovely that I'm involved. And the reason why I'm here tonight, I think, is because the libraries know that I love books. Put your hands in your ear and show, yeah, if you love books too. Yes, books are amazing. Books are magic. I love writing books. I love holding books. I love opening books and looking through the pages. You never know what you're going to find next. Looking at the illustrations, looking at the words, hearing the magic stories. And you know what? There is nothing better than sharing a magic story with somebody you love. Catching up, maybe in the morning, maybe in the middle of the day, and especially last thing at night. It is the best way to get yourself ready for a good night's sleep. And so tonight it's really lovely that I'm here with you and I'm going to share some of my favorite stories with you before you get ready to go to sleep. But first, before we start, I need your help. This is my story box, and inside I've got a few things that are going to tell us about what our first story is about. But I need you to help me open this box. What we're going to do is we're going to knock on the lid 5 times. Will you help me? Yes. Are you ready? Yes. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's have a look and see what's in our books today. Well, in here I can see my special friend, my cuddly. But she's a little bit shy, so I know. After 3, shall we all say hello? Nice and gentle, not too loud, just so that we don't scare her. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Hello. Bebo, hello. This is Rabbit. Oh. Let's try again. And this time, let's give her a little gentle wave and a smile so she can see what we mean. Ready? Steady? 1, 2, 3. Hello. She's waving back. If you have a cuddly with you now, why doesn't your cuddly wave to my cuddly? Hello. Oh, reading books with cuddlies is such a lovely thing to do. I really hope you've got someone there. And if you haven't, maybe later on you can go and find a cutchy cuddly and curl up with your favourite book. Now, there's something else in this box I can hear. I'm going to pop you up here and I'm going to take it out and I'm going to show it to you now. I wonder if you can hear this. Why don't you close your eyes and have a little listen? Ready? Can you hear it? This is my clock and it's making a really little sound. You know, when we share stories, we need to use lots of different skills and the listening is really important. So with your child, it's a great idea to play listening games and you can try and guess what these sounds are and imitate them. It's really lovely as well. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Can you make that noise? Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. It's a nice noise. It's a quiet noise. It's a little noise. But when I do this, that's a loud noise. Wake up. It's really loud. My story today is all about a little rabbit and loud noises. It's one of my favourite stories and it's by somebody. You've probably read some of her books. If you go to a library, they have hundreds of her books. She is called Julia Donaldson. And Julia Donaldson writes some really great books for littlies. She uses lots of lovely rhymes, which is great for listening to sounds and playing with sounds and having fun with sounds. And it's really good when you start to learn how to spell too. So this book is called Tales from Acorn Wood. And it's got 3 stories, but this one is my favourite story. It's called Rabbit's Map. It's a really interactive book. You can get cutched up and play with it to find out what happens next. Now, I'm going to ask you a question. How do you think Rabbit is feeling? I wonder what is happening. I know. Let's turn the page and find out. Ready? Steady? Let's turn the page. Oh, Rabbit's feeling sleepy. She curls up in a chair. Doctor! Who's that? Oh, dear. It's Build-A-Bear. Poor Rabbit. She's got woken up by that loud noise. Let's find out what happens next. Ready, steady, turn the page. Oh, where can Rabbit have her nap? This window seat looks nice. Oh, Bang! Clash! Who's that? Oh no! A band of mice. Can you see what these mice are doing? They're playing a lot of loud instruments. Poor rabbit. Ready? Steady? Turn the page. Oh, rabbit's in her deck chair. Oh, those would be so good. What's that? Crack! Crack! What's that? It's Fox. She's chopping wood. Look at that. What a lot of noise. Poor rabbit. Steady. Turn the page. A shady tree, says rabbit. Ah, oh, the kind of spot I like. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. Who's that? Shall we have a look? It's Tortoise on his bike. I love making that noise. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. Do you want to join in and do it with me? Here we go. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. Who's that? It's Tortoise on his bike. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, rabbit, you got woken up again. Poor tired rabbit goes back home. She yawns and rubs her eyes. Rat-a-tat-tat. Who's that? Shall we see? Your friends with a surprise. Surprise! I wonder what the surprise could be. Let's have a look. Ready, steady. Turn the page. Tra-la-la, hush a bunny, tra-la-la. We'll sing you off to sleep. Hush a bunny, tra-la-la. What's that? Take a peek. Oh, look. Rabbit's finally found somewhere quiet to sleep. Night-night, rabbit. Sweet dream. Isn't that a lovely story? All about rabbit trying to go to sleep. And do you know what? I know a little song all about a rabbit going to sleep. I wonder if you know it. It's the one about the bunnies. See the little bunnies sleeping in the afternoon? Do you know that one? So if you want to, you can join in yourself. Or maybe if you've got a cuddly, you could do it with your cuddly. So what we're going to do is start off really quiet. And then suddenly we can get really noisy. Here we go. See the little bunny sleeping in the afternoon. Shall we wake them with a little tune? Oh, so still. Are they ill? Wake up soon. Come on, little bunny, time to wake up. Hop, little bunny, hop, hop, hop. 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 Oh, little bunny, you look very smart. Can you see what bunny's wearing? She's wearing her pajamas. She's wearing her lovely spotty pajamas. Have you got a nice pair of pajamas on? Or maybe you're going to get them on later. So I have made some pajamas out of paper. I did some painting, which was great fun, with some lovely bright colours. Look, there's the trousers and there's the top. They go together. And I used lots of different things. I used some of these to make my marks with. You see? And then also I used a straw, and straws are really good for making dots with, little tiny dots. Can you see? And also I used a straw, which is down there, to make nice lines. And then I got some really watery paint and I got a straw and I blew the paint all across the page. That was really good fun. And I'm going to use these to make pajamas for a game I'm going to play with you now. Can you see? I've got my washing line with some very smart pajamas hanging on there. I've got some spotty ones. I've got ones with owls on, night owls. Woo-hoo-hoo. And I've got some flowery ones, all hanging on a line. And you can play some lovely pair games, which is really good for your memory, because, you know, stories need a little bit of memory. You have to remember words. And when you're reading, learning to read, you have to remember all those letters and sounds. So playing memory games is an excellent pre-reading skill that you need to get going. And you can play a game like matching pairs, or you can play this game, which I've just written a little poem for. I hung out rabbit's pajamas on my washing line. I hung out rabbit's pajamas and the weather was just fine. But the cold wind blew. It was such a windy day. You're going to make the wind noise too. It was such a windy day, it blew rabbit's pajamas far away. Oh, which one of the pajamas is going to be blown away? Can you tell me? Is it the flowery ones? Is it the night owl? Or is it the spotted ones? Can you see which one's missing? Did you get it right? Which one is missing? Yeah, it was the spotty pajamas that got blown away. Should we do that one more time? All right. If you can remember any of the words, you can join in with me. Here we go. I hung out rabbit's pajamas on my washing line. Join in. I hung out rabbit's pajamas on the washing line. I hung out rabbit's pajamas and the weather was just fine. I hung out rabbit's pajamas and the weather was just fine. But the cold wind blew. Joining in. The cold wind blew. It was such a windy day, it blew my rabbit's pajamas far, far away. Do you want to see which one of the pajamas is missing? Is it the spotty ones? Is it the night owl? Woo-hoo. Or is it the curly flowers? Did you guess? Which one was blown far, far away? Ready, steady. Ah, yeah. It was the night owl pajamas. Look at that. Aren't they lovely? I've got to pop it back on the line. We'll do it one more time. I hung out rabbit's pajamas on my washing line altogether. I hung out rabbit's pajamas on the washing line. I hung out rabbit's pajamas and the weather was just fine. But the cold wind blew. And it blew. It was such a windy day. It blew Rabbit's jammers away. Can you see which one of the pajamas is going? Is it the spots? Is it the night owl? Or is it the curly whirly flowers? Can you guess which one it is? Ready, steady. Yes, the curly whirly flowers got blown away. Let's pop it back on the line. There we go. Yeah. Making things to do with stories is really lovely because you can talk about the story afterwards and just keep it going alive, thinking about it, imagining in our heads. Stories are really important to have with us all the time. Now then, I noticed those owls on those pajamas, and those owls are nighttime animals. They love sleeping in the day and waking up at night. Ooh. Can you make that sound? Ooh. Let's make a big room full of little night owls. Ooh. Now this story is a big favourite, and I bet if you go in your library, you'll find it. It's a lovely story for joining in, and getting our littlies to join in with words is really, really lovely. It's really inclusive, and getting them to start to look at books and understand that there's magical words inside. And this story has got one of my favorite words of all time. It's a little word and it says wow. Do you want to say that with me? Ready, steady. Wow. We can say it really quickly, wow, or we could say a really big wow. Should we say a big one? Yeah, ready, steady. Wow. We say wow when we see something amazing. And in this book, our character, the owl, sees lots of amazing things that she's never seen before. Wow, said the owl, written by Tim Hopgood, a really good writer. Go to a library and find lots of his lovely books. Wow, said the owl. Wow, said the owl. What can you see? It's a beautiful owl in a tree. At night, when we are feeling tired and ready for bed, owls are just waking up. Owls live in a nighttime world. They have eyes that can see in the dark. They've got big eyes. But this little owl was a curious owl, and instead of staying awake all night, as little owls are supposed to do, she took a long nap and woke up just before dawn. Now, I'm going to turn the page, and I want you to say, wow. Are you ready? Wow, said the owl. She couldn't believe her eyes. The sky was pink. Wow, said the owl, as the yellow sun shone. So we could keep this really simple and just say yellow. Wow, said the owl when she saw all the leaves were green. Wow, owl said the owl, as the pretty red butterflies flew by. She watched them land on the bright orange flowers, which had opened up in the warm sunshine. I can see lots of different flowers in this garden. Up in the sky, the clouds turned grey and it started to rain. But the sun was still shining.
I love this next page. Are you ready to help me? Now we're going to have to say a really big wow for this page. Okay, ready, steady. Wow! Oh, look at that. All those colours. The beautiful rainbow filled the sky with colour. The little owl sat happily in her tree and she watched as the sun went down and the moon came up. The daytime is full of beautiful colours, she thought. Are you ready? Should we do a big wow for this page? Yeah. Ready, steady. Wow! Wow, said the owl. The nighttime stars are the most beautiful of all. Too excited to sleep, the little owl stayed awake all night long, just like little owls are supposed to. What? A brilliant story. This story tells us a little bit about the world we live in. It tells us about all the colours that we see every day. And it maybe it will help us notice them a little bit more. Why don't you, when you go out and about tomorrow, have a really good look? And maybe if you see a sky that's pink, you could say, wow! Or maybe if you see a tree that's covered in little green leaves, you could say, wow. Or maybe you just keep your eyes open. And if you see something amazing, remember what that little owl said? Wow. I've got a big pile of stories here that I love. And do you know what? When you go to a library, you can walk away with a big pile of books that you love too. They might be books that you've never, ever seen before, but the nice thing is you can take them home and you can relax with them and you can have a really good look. And you might find your favourite book of all time. Because that's what I always say when we're learning to read. It's not just learning to read that's important. It's learning to find all of our favourite books that have ever been written that are out there. This is my girl's favourite book, I think, and it's written by, it's published by a lovely publisher called Little Tiger Press. And it's a really interactive book. And she joins in with this story, and we've read it for years and years. It hasn't got a huge story to it, but it's got lovely pictures and it's really predictable. Predicting what happens in the story is really important. And it's just lovely. We've had it for years, but it lasts really well. So have a good look in your library. This book is lovely. It's called Good Night, Everyone. And it's got the most beautiful, colourful pictures in it. Your book doesn't have to be a story. In fact, my other daughter prefers books which aren't stories. So we've got this book, which I thought was a nice book, all about the nighttime. And it's just all about what happens in the world we live in, really, and helps us explore things in a really friendly way. Look, there's some lovely little bats ready to come out. Fairy tales are really good as well for us to enjoy because there's lots of repetition and that helps our children join in with the story. So the Goldilocks and the Three Bears is lovely. It's all about Goldilocks trying out different beds. The big bed was too hard, too bumpy, just right. And it's a really good chance for us to use our funny voices. What does that big bear say? Who's been eating my porridge? What does the middle bear say? Who's been eating my porridge? What does the little bear say? Who's been eating my porridge? Eat it all up. This story here is called The Monkey Nut, and it's another favourite of ours. And it's really got very few words in, but it's all about the dynamic of arguing over something. I think that's something we all know about. So please, if you have got a library near you, please go into that library and have a good look and see if you can find your favourite. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sarah. That was so lovely. We are now going to answer a few questions from parents and carers. So if anybody watching has a question they'd like to ask Sarah about children's books or how best to read to children or some ideas for getting children really interested in books, then you can pop them in the chat box and we will answer as many as we can get through. But first of all, I have a few questions that were sent in advance. So I have a question here, Sarah, from Evan and Baby Todd. And the question is, my children like to read the same book over and over. Is there a limit to how many times you should read the same book?
No, never. And hopefully they can read it back to you at one point. No, it's lovely. And you know, I've got a favourite book that I read over and over again. I call them book, our blanket books. And I think there's a, for us it can be hard, but for the child, it's a really lovely thing to have a blanket book. And I've got a couple of blanket books that have been read to, well, I've had to share with my little one for a long time. And, you know, it's just fascinating, isn't it, how they can get into something. But there's always something there. And it's obviously something that resonates. And that's what we want. We want books to mean something. You know, that's what books are all about. So, yeah, I'm sorry if you've got a few more years ahead of that book. That's it. It won't be forever. It's precious time catching up with a book. So, yeah. Yeah.
No, it's great when a child finds a book they really love as well.
Yeah.
So I have another question here from somebody called Cassie. And Cassie's asked, do you think we should keep reading to children even when they can read themselves?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, I think there's no rules about reading, is there? And I think there's something very magic, you know, about hearing someone else read a story. You know, so, you know, my husband listens to plays on the radio while he's working in the daytime. And it's something, you know, there's something really important about listening. So if your little one is still up for having a story read to them when they're older, keep going for as long as you can, because it's magic time to sort of curl up and share a book. It really is. So I don't think there should ever be a limit. You know, I still read to my 8-year-old, and it's a really special time. You know, I don't want that to end. It will one time, but you know, it's a lovely thing to have.
Definitely. So I have a question here from Isabel, who has said, my 3-year-old has not had the fun of socializing because of COVID, with play groups and things cancelled so often. Can reading help her catch up with these social skills? And do you have any kind of other advice for people in that situation?
Oh, you know, it's been a really tough time. I worked for a charity before COVID, and we used to have, you know, baby groups. And it's a, you know, the brain is a social organ. I read this, you know, and it's really important, isn't it, for our children to try and have those experiences. And obviously it's been really hard.
The wonderful thing about stories is that they do allow us to enter other worlds, and we can learn from our characters' journeys, the language that they use, the situations that they find themselves in. So although it isn't a replacement, and you can't replace the actual face-to-face, the eye contact, you know, all of the nuances you get in person, I think, you know, stories are really important and really important at the moment. So my heart goes out to you. You know, I know it's a difficult time, but I think stories are very, very important as a way of sharing them, you know, and looking at the world, but also, you know, maybe doing interactive sessions, you know, online with other parents is a nice way as well, because you can play games, and maybe if you go to the library and you'll get the same book, or, you know, take it in turns to share the books and the stories, you know, maybe that's a way of doing it too, setting it up.
Thank you, that's some really great advice there. I just seen a message in the chat from Rachel who has said, Lenti, I hope I pronounced that correctly, wants to share that she has read some of your books from the library, and she has some herself and she loves them.
Oh, thank you, Lenti. It's always nice to hear. Thank you very much. And I'm glad you're going to the library and finding some good books.
On that, we have a question from Charlotte, who I think is 4 years old. And she has asked, how did you come up with the story of Princess Evie?
Oh, do you know what, Charlotte? I think I was writing Princess Evie ever since I was 4 years old, because I grew up on a farm in the Black Mountains, and there was a tunnel of trees. And I really believe that there was a lot of magic things that could happen if you went through the tunnel of trees. I also loved horses. I wasn't big into riding horses, but I just love all of their personalities, how they're all a little bit different. So I just had this idea that I wanted to write about somebody who rode all these different horses, and the different horses' characters would take her to different places, different wonderful magical lands where she'd meet other characters. So that was the kind of idea that that came to me, but it took a long time for it to actually become a book. So I think the idea started when I was four and then grew, and as I got older I started to write them down in my books.
Lovely, thank you. If any of the children watching have questions as well, then feel free to put them in the chat as well. So I have a question here. Someone has said, my son has some additional learning needs and reads at a different pace to his sister. This event was lovely for them. What is your advice for including children of different ages and with different needs in sessions?
Oh, you know, I've learned a lot over the last few years, because our daughter's got a rare genetic microdeletion, chromosome deletion. And so her development has been very atypical, with speech and language delay and cognitive difficulties, you know, a whole host. And actually, you know, having worked with early years, you know that children are all different and they develop at a different pace, but it's also realizing that children develop in different ways and our brains work differently. And I think stories are really important, because it's about modeling language, it's about encouraging a kind of physical connection. It's such a sensory thing, a book, you know, to look through together. And, you know, it's about just finding a way that you can engage them, to, you know, your child, to sort of, you know, start hearing words or start joining in or asking questions and being curious. So, you know, I think you can use story as a really powerful tool to help children with additional needs or atypical, you know, ways of being. You know, they really help. And like I said, you know, this one here, the monkey nut, it hasn't really got a story, you know, and my daughter really enjoys books like this, but it's very sort of active in a way, you know, and it really does encourage the readers to sort of join in. And actually, when I showed her this page for the first time, she jumped. It was, you know, it's really just finding books that kind of do sort of just
clue in there. So this is Monkey Nut, and it's Simon and Schuster, which is one of my publishers. But you know, I'm sure that there's lots of other books out there, which again is why a library's great, because you can just go in there and spend however long you've got, really, just on the floor with your child looking through. But I know that story has helped our daughter's language development. You know, and we still read books every night, and it's really helped her sort of understand who she is and the world around her. So yeah.
No, that's brilliant. Thank you very much. So I think we've probably got time for one last question. So Maisie has said, what books would you like to see written for children that are currently out there at the moment?
Sorry, what books would I like?
What books would you like to see out there that aren't currently published?
Oh, so that's
kind really of books that you'd like to see out in the world.
I love fairy tales. I grew up listening to traditional fairy tales, and it's quite lovely to sort of see how people have started playing around with fairy tales, because they're powerful stuff. They're really powerful. But I think they could do with a little bit of updating sometimes. And I think it's really important as well, when we tell stories, we're not afraid of changing pronouns, or we're not afraid of sort of, you know, changing what's happening here and there necessarily, because it is about making stories accessible, and they should always be, you know, accessible and inclusive to everybody. So I just think that whatever story it is that you are writing or want to write, it's really important to think about the messages you might be giving out, and just making sure that you're just making sure that it's inclusive and available to sort of everybody, and not leaving anyone out.
Lovely. No, that's brilliant. And I'm a big fan of fairy tales too.
You can't beat them.
Children and adults to read. So I think that has brought us to the end of our event. So thank you so much to everybody who watched along. And thank you especially to Sarah, and also to Nicola for welcoming us. So all of Sarah's books, including A Cuddle and a Kutch, are available to buy in bookshops and online. And of course, you can borrow them from the library too. So please keep visiting the Winter of Wellbeing website, which you can find at winterofwellbeing.readingagency.org.uk. So you can see what's happening in the weeks ahead, including, of course, the launch of the Winter of Wellbeing book list, which has been nominated by young people across Wales. And that will be revealed on Monday the 14th. So keep an eye out for that. So I think that's everything for this evening. So thank you so much again, Sarah, and thank you everyone.
Oh, thank you for having me.
And have a lovely evening. Diolch.
Diolch, hwyl.